Hey folks, SNK Gaming here. Since Battlefield 2042 released, you have heard many players complain about aim assist. One side has said it is far too strong, with the other side saying the opposite. They feel it is far too weak, it's non-existent, and it actually pushes them off target. You would think one of these sides would be wrong, but they aren't. Both are in fact correct. But how can this be? Well, what the majority of the player base do not realise is that they are in fact talking about two different elements that make up aim assist. In my most recent video, I showed you how strong the slowdown aim assist can be and how it can help with recoil control due to its strength. Slowdown is designed to lower your sensitivity when on or near target to help you stay on target. But what I have recently discovered is that this can be a huge negative when you are engaged a moving target. Compared to previous Battlefield titles, slowdown on Battlefield 2042 is so much stronger. However, another aspect of slowdown is tracking. In previous Battlefield games, the tracking aspect helped a lot with staying on and tracking moving targets. It is slightly different to slowdown. As long as you were putting input into your right stick, it actually required little or less effort to stay on target. But on Battlefield 2042, this aspect is simply not there, or it is super weak. Take a look at this here. My friend Scooter is moving backwards and forwards here, and as he does so, I will be trying to get my aim on him and keep it on him. Such a simple task shouldn't be an issue for me, but it is. I really struggle with keeping my aim on them as they move around. It requires me to push really hard to the left and right on my right stick. So why is this happening? Well, the slowdown aim assist is like a bubble around the player. When you hit that bubble, your aim starts to slow down, and this is designed to keep you on target, and it requires more movement on the right stick to go the same distance compared to before. This is illustrated by the green to red dots. In previous games, it was during this change in sensitivity when tracking would have kicked in and aided aiming even further. So slowdown provided the control when on the player, and the tracking provided that sticky effect that helped you follow their movements. When working together and in unison, aiming on a target felt smooth, compared to slowdown alone. With this tracking element, the movement required by the player to benefit from it was still the same. You couldn't just put your crosshair on the target and leave it to follow the player, you still had to put input into the stick, and then this aided your aiming and helped track the player for you, and this is illustrated here by the green to yellow dots. But remember, this tracking aspect is barely there in Battlefield 2042, so slowdown effectively acts like a barrier around the enemy player. Once you hit it, you need to push on your stick much more to get on target. Previously, the tracking would have aided this. This becomes even harder when the player is past you and running away from you. Your aim is then playing catch up. They can actually start running away from you. The lower your in-game sensitivity, the harder the time you're going to have with this. How so? Well, my in-game sensitivity is 100 soldier stick and 100 zoom, and I struggle to break past this barrier a lot of the time. I constantly feel my aim bouncing off this invisible barrier, and that's because the movement and force I am trying to use to break into it and onto the player, it isn't enough. You can clearly see when this is occurring in this and the next series of clips. It looks like my aim is stuttering. So with a lower sensitivity, it is even harder to break through this bubble. I cannot imagine how those with lower sensitivities even force their crosshair on the target. It might not even be possible in some instances. Think about it. Slowdown slows down your aim a lot. If you play with a sensitivity of 50 or less, your aiming speed around this slowdown could be slower than the player's running speed. How can you catch them when you hit that bubble around them? You end up just following behind them, and that's what I've noticed myself. Trying to get my crosshair onto them, you just end up following behind them. And that is what you see occurring in this clip. Only once the player stops moving am I able to catch up with them. But because I had already started to force my aim even harder onto them, I overshoot them and then have to readjust my aim to get on target. This here is exactly why you have some saying it feels too strong. In instances where players are stationary, it certainly is, and it helps with recoil control as I demonstrated in my previous video. But when it comes to moving targets and the tracking aspect, it is so weak and it can be really difficult to stay on target or even acquire your target. This needs to change. Slowdown is causing very inconsistent gunfights. They need to reduce the amount of slowdown and increase the tracking aspect to give better balance, because that's what you need here. You need balance between these two aspects, because one is far stronger and it's affecting the other. It's making everything feel very inconsistent. For now, I recommend setting your slowdown to 50 or 60% and see how that helps you. I don't recommend changing your sensitivity until after you try adjusting slowdown first and see how that works for you. Folks, I hope this video has been informative for you. If you enjoyed, please drop a like on the video, put a comment below to give your thoughts on this and how you're feeling slowdown has been affecting you in-game. Also, if you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button, join the SMK community. We're nearly there, folks. The 10k is nearly here. Thank you for watching. I hope you all had a great new year. Stay safe out there, folks, and I'll catch you again in the next video.